Recording, rolling, live. What's good, guys? Simeon Panda here, and welcome to my channel. Guys, it came to my attention that I have not produced a hamstring video for you guys ever. Like, literally ever. Go through all my videos on YouTube and there are none on hamstrings. And there are two reasons why, and I sussed it out. Firstly, when I choose to do hamstrings is a Sunday. It's a relaxed day for me. I don't find hamstrings too strenuous, so when I do it, it's just a nice chill day, you know? And it's not a day that I would consider filming. That's the first reason. So that's probably why I've never thought to, you know, film this workout. Second reason is hamstrings doesn't really interest people that much, but that is the specific reason why I'm recording it today, because it is so important. Something I've been doing for a long time is separating my hamstrings and my quads days, you know? So when you see those videos where you see me doing like squats and leg press, etc., and all variations of squats, you never see me doing any hamstrings exercises, and that's because it's on a different day. And I've never shown you that day until today. But what you need to know is that the exercises I'm gonna do today contribute to me being able to perform form as well as I do on my squats. So when you guys are saying, you know, how do you go so low? Does it hurt your knees, etc., etc., etc.? No, because my hamstrings are strong and my mobility in my hips is great, and it's actually the hips that are the key factor with that deep squat that I do. My knees are fine, don't worry about the knees. It's the being able to dip with the hips. So this is just one routine that I do for hamstrings. We're actually outside, so it's gonna be all the equipment that you can use outside. I do another variation of hamstring routines inside, which I'll show you another day, but today we're doing it outside. What I'm gonna do is I'm not gonna talk you through the actual workout. I'm gonna do it, get on, get cracking, and then show you afterwards, talk about why I did what I did and how I did what I did. All right, you good with that? Let's do it, let's work. And we're done, guys. What a fantastic workout. I am ready to go and lie down. But before I do that, obviously, I need to talk to you guys through what I did so that you understand it and you can implement it in your own routines. So as always, I always start off with the compound lifts first. And with the barbell LDLs that I was doing, it's a posterior chain movement. So we're using our glutes, we're using our hamstrings. I think one of the things you need to understand before even trying this exercise is the difference between an RDL and a barbell stiff leg deadlift. And one of the main differences is that the bar is away from you with a barbell stiff leg deadlift. So you're not gonna really bend in the knees. You're gonna keep the barbell away from you, straight back as you come down and up. But with RDL, you wanna bring the bar as close to your shins as possible. It's a hip hinge movement, so you're gonna tilt at the hip. And as you come down, you're gonna keep a neutral spine and bring the bar down, but you're not gonna touch the floor. That's the other thing that's different from an RDL and a regular deadlift. You don't touch the floor. You're keeping that tension, you know, so it's nice and slow. That is a great exercise. You're gonna love it. It's one that I do with dumbbells as well, and I go super heavy with dumbbells. I've actually gone up to 200-pound dumbbells, you know, with that exercise. I've got really strong lower back and hamstrings, and RDLs is definitely an exercise that I use to improve that strength. That's exercise I love starting with. So we did about six sets. So as always, I'm high volume of everything. I don't really tend to do a variety of exercises. I choose the exercises that I feel will give me the most improvement, and I go ham on them at different rep ranges and different weights, you know. With hamstrings, I tend not to go as heavy as I do with other exercises, because you need to make sure that you're focused and that the movement is controlled. So I don't really go too heavy on that. I just want to feel the movement. We then moved on to good mornings, a fantastic exercise that a lot of people shy away from because it looks difficult, and it actually is. But notice how I start every exercise. So you saw when I started the barbell LDLs, I just mimicked the movement. That is my warm-up. Dynamic stretching is a way of preparing yourself for an exercise by simply mimicking the movement you're about to do. So when you saw me getting ready for the good mornings, I acted as if I had a bar behind my neck and I mimicked the movement I'm about to do. I got myself in a movement pattern. Then as you saw with both exercises, I grabbed the bar, just the bar, and I started with just the bar. You know, don't be afraid to start with the bar. There's no point putting on weight and getting stuck into it, especially if you're new to certain exercises. So yeah, we went on to good mornings, and as you see, you just tilt at the hip, you keep your back straight, neutral spine, and you slowly lower yourself down and raise back up. It's very important to have control with this movement, and do not run before you walk. Don't try and go super heavy. This is not one of those. Remember where the weight is. The weight is on your neck, and a lot of pressure is gonna be on that lower back, you know? So don't try and go super heavy. It's all about control with that exercise. So as usual, I try and do compounds first. I then like to move on to isolation exercises. Now, today I only showed you the isolation exercises that we could do in this environment, which is outside. So the next exercise I did was a single leg hamstring curl, elevated. It's an exercise that you can't really tell just by looking how intense it is, but it really is. I mean, we got some angles to show you the leg that is working, which is the leg that is on the actual step. That is the leg that is working. It's a hamstring curl. So even though you see my leg going up and down, what we're actually doing is a small contraction, imagine a little bicep curl, just like that, a little bicep curl. That's what we're doing with the hamstring. It's a little curl. Every time I go up, it's curling the hamstring. And it's very intense, you know? After that exercise, I then moved on to do an elevated hamstring bridge. And again, another exercise that you can't really tell how intense it is unless you're doing it. But what we're doing, again, essentially, we're just curling the hamstring. Small contraction, but intense, and you hold it as well. So every time you saw me come up, I held for a brief second, and then I let myself back down in a controlled fashion. And we did high reps with those. So I think we did like 12 reps per set on that. I then did calves. I always do calves last, you know? So recently, it's kind of interesting. As I've been in the gym, I've had people coming up to me asking me about calves. And I'm like, you know, this is me that never used to have any. And now they're decent. They're not great. They're not the best, but they're decent. And they only became decent because I was consistent at them. And they will at some point go from decent to really good. And how's that gonna happen? It's gonna be through consistency and through dedicating enough time for them to grow. So after almost every session, I hit calves, you know? So I just wanted to show you guys, I do that literally 5 days a week. You know, after every session, I hit calves. So I'm gonna bring you another hamstring session, probably indoors, so I can show you some more things that I do. But I hope you enjoyed that. I'm coming back at you guys. You know, I know there's been a little break. Like I said in the last video, I've been super busy, but I'm on it. Don't worry, you know, I'm coming for you. I'm gonna be giving you these videos. Tell your friends to come, and I appreciate you. Guys, we hit 2 mil. I didn't even do an announcement. I forgot to do an announcement, a shout out. I'm very, very appreciative that we reached 2 mil, guys. That shows a lot. And it's actually on, at the time of this video, I think 2,050,000. So I should have done this a while ago, you know. But thank you for the 2 mil. Really appreciate it. Peace out.